A good set of tyres for your bike is absolutely essential, but they're actually something taken for granted a lot of the time, which is a shame because there is so much tech crammed into a set of tyres, which is why Vittoria invited me out to their factory facility here in Thailand to check out exactly how they make these tyres containing graphene and a quadruple compound. Get ready for some serious tyre tech. Vittoria is a brand well known amongst our tarmac loving friends and has a rich history dating back, in fact, to 1853. Now, it's no secret that they make some of the fastest rolling road tyres on earth, and as a result, there's been plenty of astonishingly fast riders and racers using it, and teams too, sometimes on occasion even when they're supposed to be using other brands. But in the background, they've been quietly making waves in the mountain bike world, making some really advanced tyres using the wonder stuff graphene and having some really sophisticated manufacturing techniques. As you've probably noticed, I'm sat outside the Lion Tyres factory. Now, Lion Tyres Thailand is a production company owned by Vittoria. Now, this was set up in 1988 when Vittoria Tyres were having a bit of a reorganisation and decided this was the best place to have the facility. The clear reasons for that: rubber is a natural product of Thailand and they're absolute experts in it. Lion Tyres Thailand employs 1,300 members of staff and they are 100% Thai. And I have to say, the way they run this place is staggering. Back in 2013, Vittoria opened an $11 million facility with a totally unique machine to them that enables them to manufacture a 4C compound, something that is exclusive to Vittoria. Now, Lion Tyre Company, they do manufacture for other brands, but the 4C technology and the graphene technology is completely exclusive to Vittoria Tyres. Now, this is a sample of a tyre ridden by Tom Wilson, a UK enduro rider, that's been used at two of the EWS rounds, including one at Finale Liguri. Now, that is testament to the quality of this tyre because of the fact it still has its knobs on it and still got plenty of life left in it. If you ignore the fact that it's cut up so I can see this sample, this tyre is a 4C tyre. It's got four compounds in it, it's got graphene in the casing, and it also has sidewall inserts. That is the latest tech. But let's find out a little bit more about that, shall we? In particular, graphene. What is graphene and why is it even in a set of tyres? Well, first up, graphene comes from graphite. Well, it's essentially a single atomic layer of graphite and is made up of tightly bonded carbon atoms that form a hexagonal lattice. Because graphene is a single atom layer, it can be used to fill molecule holes, which is where the usage comes in on tyres. We'll get to that shortly. Graphene is the thinnest known material, and in a strand is a million times thinner than a human hair. A million times thinner. If that's still not enough, 1 gram of graphene can cover 2,600 square meters. Get your head around that. Graphene's also the strongest known material and works out about 200 times stronger than steel. Add to that, that it's also the most conductive material, so has huge opportunity for use in other sectors, and it's also 6 times lighter than steel. This stuff really is next level. Now, here's a few stats about graphene and the way it's used in tyres. It can add 4% puncture resistance when used in casing. And interestingly, 5% more of your power output goes into forward momentum. Probably one of the biggest factors about graphene inclusion in tyres is that they allow for dramatically increased grip in wet conditions. Now, this really is something special for mountain bikers. However, Vittoria are keen to say that adding too much graphene to tyres can firm up a tyre too much, giving characteristics that are not beneficial and actually the complete opposite. Now, Vittoria have applied real science here and they've used real scientists in white jackets. They spent a lot of money developing this technology and you're going to start to see this included in everything they manufacture moving forwards.
So 4C, what exactly does that mean? It means there's 4 compounds within the tyre. Now, traditionally you'd have a single compound tyre and you could have softer compounds and harder compounds. Now, those harder compounds will roll faster, but as a result of that, they will grip less. Softer compounds the opposite way around. but also with a softer compound, the knobbles are subject to rolling around, which means A, it's not going to be that consistent when you ride, and also they can actually break down in certain situations and knobbles can tear off. And by having four compounds, it means the tyre has more support. So you can cater for having those shoulders, enabling them to have nice soft rubber on the top to give you the traction. You've got a firm base on underneath to give it that support so it can cut in and do its job. It's the same principle with the center band of tread. You have to have a happy medium between how fast a tyre can roll and then how much traction you're going to be able to get from the tyre. And of course, that also applies under braking. So by having those four compounds, you get the best of all worlds. It actually means the tyre is more durable as well, especially given how soft the tyre is on the top and how much traction you can get from that. Now I'm just going to give you a little demonstration here. So this is a short a tyre durometer tester. And this physically shows you the differences in the compounds. So you'll see if I measure this, you're looking at about 50 odd on here. And then if you actually go to the top of the actual tyre compound on the tread there, you're at 42. So that's much, much softer for that all important traction. Now the first stage of how a tyre is made, of course, is with the rubber itself. Now natural rubber in a latex format comes from trees just like this, and Thailand is famous for it. You can see here what is scarred a tree and it funnels down here into these collection pots. Now of course the rubber that comes from the tree is completely natural, but in order for the rubber itself in the tyres to be completely stable and offer the best performance, it needs to be mixed with synthetic rubber, and that's something that happens at the compounds development section of their factory. Now there are quite literally hundreds of steps of designing, developing, testing and manufacturing tyres, and this room is dedicated to testing certain aspects. Now this machine is super, super cool, and it's essentially a huge super tech wheel jig. So this measures all of the factors in the wheel to make sure it's completely straight. So when the tyres get tested for various things, which I'm going to show you, you know that the wheel is nothing to do with that. It effectively takes it out of the equation. Now I think I'll be all right if I just hit the run button here, and you're going to be able to see this kickstart. Now check it out, it's got all the same features that you'd expect to see on a really technical wheel jig. And I'm sure if Calvin's watching this, he will absolutely love this. I'm just going to leave this running in the background here, and we're going to check out another really cool thing. I mean, as you can see, there's a burst pressure test, an air leakage test here, another air leakage test, and there is this one, which is a particular favourite. Now this is to test the puncture resistance of the casing. The bit that's on the top here at the moment is 8 millimetres, so that's something far commonly seen in the motorbike world. But in the mountain bike world, we have far thinner things to do the puncturing. So you have a really fine one here. You have something here to simulate the sort of effect you would get from a sidewall slash or something like that. And of course, from pinches. And this is where it gets cool. If I just hit this button, you can watch this drive down into the tire. And the whole point is to test consistency of the tire casing to make sure they can withstand everything that they need to in an off-road environment. Now around here they've got something called the Ozone test machine. Now this is absolutely amazing. So effectively you're putting O3, known as ozone, directly onto the tyres, and the job of that is to simulate the sort of stress that a tyre has in its lifetime. Now have you ever noticed that really old tyres, they look perished, the rubber quite literally cracks and peels away. That is what this machine is designed to do, it ages the tyres. So they can monitor how long it takes for the tyre to actually start breaking down. But you can't actually see that unless it's all shut. So let's move on to another cool machine down here. Now this one's a rolling resistance test. This particular wheel's actually got a road tyre on it, so we're not too interested in that one for now. And down here you've got something that is so cool. So this effectively takes a core sample of the tyre. So you can see here on the casing itself, 2.8 mil, 2.6 mil, 2.2 mil, 2 mil. It actually carves out sections of the tyre, so you can see the consistency in how it's moulded. Now tyres are taken completely at random from every single batch. And if there's a problem at any stage during the manufacturing, all stop. That batch will be put to the side, they'll do more testing on it. Because the whole point of this facility is to have the best possible quality and ensure complete consistency. So no matter what tyre you're buying, it's the same quality as the next. What a cool setup. Love this sort of stuff. So this essentially is the natural rubber. The process of everything starts right here. The rubber's mixed with several additives and synthetic rubber which stabilizes the compound. In addition to the additive powders, the graphene flakes are added and carefully measured out here, strictly following Vittoria's secret recipe.
So once a combination of powders has been settled, they're mixed together with oils from these Zeppelin systems here. And then it all funnels in along with silica into this giant hopper at the end here. And then that goes straight downstairs to the next part of the process, which is a giant mixer to get it ready to turn it into rubber. So now this is the rubber finally coming out of the machine, now it's being mixed. And you might notice it is actually sort of got some steam coming off it. It's about 150 degrees at the moment, and that's just from the friction of that mixing process.
It's then carried swiftly up a belt into the homogenization process. This basically is where the air bubbles are ironed out of the rubber, and then it's prepared for curing. It's treated so it doesn't stick to itself, basically, and then it's stored and cooled for up to 8 hours.
Following the curing process, it's heated in order to vulcanize that rubber. And of course, once it's vulcanized, then it's time to start putting the stuff through the really, really cool 4C machine. So once a batch of rubber has been made, they take samples of that batch and it goes through all of these processes here. So they basically get a little puck of rubber, and then those pucks of rubber are exposed to various different tests. Now some of these are ozone tests, and there's a really cool one up here that's really, really quite vital for mountain biking. It deals with the rebound of the rubber. Now, as we know, we want slow rebound rubber on certain types of tyres, so downhill tyres. Now, what you're looking for here is a low number, as you see, rebond resilience tester. So if I hit this button here, you can see the little puck of rubber down the bottom there, and it's measuring the speed at which the device rebounds. Really cool little piece of kit. Now, as well as the rebound, you need to also test the tensile strength, which basically measures when the rubber can break. So they take a sample here, as you can see in the background, they load it onto this machine. It's a tension meter, effectively. You can see the sample going, and they measure the point at which it actually breaks, so you can test the rubber for strength and consistency. Now, once the rubber has been finalized, it's into here, which is the 4C facility, to get everything finished up. Now, this is the only facility in the world that is like this, and it cost in a region of $11 million to build this. And in fact, they had to house the factory around this. This is the only machine of its kind in the world, and the only one that can push out 4 compounds into one tire. As you can see here, you've got batches of rubber prepared to go into the machine. Now, the machine is capable of taking up to 4 batches of different compound rubber. That's the whole point. As you can see here, they've got the feeder systems. They've got 4 of these, and at the bottom of each of these, they have a different compound rubber. It depends on the tyre that's being made, which formula is going in. And it gets taken up, it goes through a metal detector because it has to make sure there's no metal particles because that will damage the machine. And then it goes into giant hoppers where it's all funneled into a die. Now, the dies are made up of metal and they have to be heated to 100 degrees before they can be used. Now, this is one from a Martello tyre here. They're heated up in an oven right here next to me, and this is how the rubber is extruded through here in that 4C compound.
Now, once a compound has been extruded, it then follows a series of conveyor belts where it's subjected to coolant and then eventually spooled up underneath. Now, this rubber, which will be the tread of the tyre, is then sent to be constructed with the rest of the tyre carcass, including the bead, the stickers, and that all-important casing. In the assembly of the nylon casing, to make it tough enough and to allow it to seal to the rim correctly, it needs to be bonded with rubber. Now, what you can see here is this tan wool rubber being homogenized to flatten and heat it up so it's pliable enough to be merged with that nylon casing. The rubber joins the nylon through a series of rollers to perfectly line up the materials to one another. Once the bonding is complete, it will be rolled up and join the rest of the tire for the next part of the construction process. Now, this is absolutely astonishing to see firsthand. The workers are so talented, and I'm completely shocked how quickly they can build a tyre from all of these separate components and how accurately they can do this. Each worker has a bespoke machine purpose-built for this use, and it's absolutely insane to see the machine because it's completely hand-calibrated. It has laser guides for perfect precision when cutting the pieces into shape. Firstly, the casing is rolled on where then is providing the foundation for the rest of the tyre. The bead is then reeled on for 3 rotations on each side. The drum then folds the casing over the bead on each side, which also reinforces the strength of the casing. Then of course there's sidewall reinforcement. Next up comes the chafer. This is essentially a covering for the bead, and really it's what helps make the tyre tubeless compatible. This is quite a key part of the tyre. And now finally, the 4C graphene infused tread is applied to the centre of the tyre, and note how this is hand cut again. This is so accurate, I can't actually believe this is done by hand. Amazing to see. Now it may look a bit flat now, but that is all going to change in the next step. Last little thing here is a thin layer of lacquer is applied for the finishing touches of the relevant Vittoria logo stickers and identification on the sidewall of that tyre, and then it's ready for the final stage of the process. Now this is the very final part of the puzzle. The tyre goes in like this with the extruded rubber that we saw coming out of the machine earlier. It goes into the curing machine where it's pressurised under immense pressure and heat. Any second now, you're going to see this open and a brand new tyre, one of these, is going to come out. This is like the coolest thing. Here we go, check this out. Went in like this. Yeah. Brand new tyre. So there you go, that is essentially how Vittoria make tyres. Very unique tyres, again using the graphene and the four compounds, totally unique to them. If you've got any questions about how the tyres are made, or you want to know anything else about tyre tech, I'm going to do a special ask following this video, so get involved in the comments underneath. And if you like this and you're really interested in how tyres are made, give us a huge thumbs up, and don't forget to click subscribe and share this around.